go around the Sigma node plane. And this is exactly what happens. We can compute this monogamy of the disk amplitude exactly using this localization formula, as I mentioned before. And this is the exact computation. And this is basic, and then if you do a contour integral, you get exactly T, the Toulouse coupling. So we have shown that the quasi-string amplitude is expressed as a sum of the holes of open string amplitudes, and each hole has a property of the disk and contributes the factor of T. And this is what we wanted to show. Now, this completes the proof. However, there is one more thing I need to tell you. That is that there is a possibility that the entire worship in the pure C phase, like this. From the point of view of game theory, this is a very peculiar situation, since we are saying that the entire worship is a hole. Now, there is no final diagram corresponding to such worship. In fact, we can compute this amplitude exactly, and we find this result, which is singular for small Toulouse coupling, so 2g minus 2 is positive, so this is singular. And this again is peculiar from the point of view of Toulouse expansion, since it assumes that we can expand the Gauss amplitude in positive power of t, and we are getting this divergent result. From the point of view of quasi-string, however, it is quite natural, since the target space becomes singular when t goes to 0, as I have been said a couple of times, and the pure phase is basically capturing the singular behavior of the worship. Well, now, to understand what this term means in the Gauss theory, we can try to sum this over all genera. Now here, chi, I didn't tell you, but it's a Schrödinger characteristic of the moduli space of Riemann surface, which is expressed in terms of the Bernoulli number. The important thing is that you have this factor 2g minus 2 here, but then you are multiplying this to sum over, and then you see that the coupling constant cancels from denominator and numerator, and in fact, this term depends only on n. And in fact, you can carry out this summation using the Binet integral, and we find that this is equal to the log of the volume of un. This is the famous MacDonald formula for the volume of the group un. It comes from the fact that the un is a product of the commutatively product of this sphere. We can then identify the major factor of the transformal functional integral. The factor is not included in the standard of Toulouse expansion, but it is there in the exact Gauss theory amplitude. So this means that the duality between the Gauss theory and the string theory goes beyond the Toulouse expansion. Now, I still have the yellow right here, so I'm just going to show you one more transparency where the same thing can be done for the case with Orient fold. Actually, after computing this, we are looking for the formula for the Euler characteristic of a surface with cross-cap, and we found that it was actually formed by most constant just last year. It is true that, because if we didn't know that, we would have predicted those numbers from this answer. So, anyway, with this note, I conclude my talk. Thank you for your attention.
Any questions, please?
This is very vague, but there's something I find confusing, which is that to really see the open string come up, the important part of the Feynman diagram is where the open strings are long.
Yes.
That's where you really see field theory, and you're trying to determine Feynman's field theory. On the other hand, in your derivation, the part where your derivation is convincing is where the tube that connects to the signal domain is long.
Indeed.
If I can finish, for the sake of everyone else, what I say, there seems to be a contact between one being long and the other one being long.
I realize that. That's a very interesting point. And probably we are saved by the fact that we are doing the topological string computation, and as far as the disk is concerned, the perimeter of the disk is not really the moduli of the Riemann surface. But that is indeed, I realize, is a puzzle. And on the other hand, I would like to point out that we did show that we can reproduce all the open string worship moduli by doing this change of variable. So it does look like this is small, but it is not really so. Oh yeah, so here is the thing. So here's an answer to you. So I believe. So that is that. So you want to look at the limit frame. The moduli around the number of the disk is very large, but in fact, that is transformed from y, because basically y gives you the size of the disk. So the moduli, if you add a hole on each world heat, what are the additional three moduli that you need? The location of the hole and the size of the hole, which is actually this y, and we found that this gives us the correct measure. Yes, in this picture, it does look like this is small, but I believe this is somehow related by modular transformation on the world heat to the case that you desire. Namely, that large y, probably that factor here would probably correspond to y goes into this direction. But we'll have to think a little bit more carefully in order to make this precise.
Is there any analog in GCD of terms singular in the Toulouse coupling?
This is typically the case that small Toulouse coupling is singular in the cross string in terms of the target space geometry. In the case of ATS5 CSP4 correspondence, the proof coupling of n equals 4 Gauss theory is related to the curvature radius of ADS5 and the radius of S5. So in order to reproduce the Toulouse expansion, you should be looking at the limit, as actually Polyakov was also saying, the limit when the radius of S3 becomes small. So you have a very situation when the target space curvature is very large, and you have a very similar situation on the Sigma model. So typically then, on quantum theory, in this case, why this quantum theory has a singularity, one way to cure it or clarify it is to realize that maybe this is signaling a new degree of freedom. In fact, in this case, the new degree of freedom is this new phase C that is appearing. you do this computation in compact and you find some similarity in some value of the parameter, the reason is sometimes that you are missing some new degrees of freedom. The conical transition of domain is another example. So in this case, it works in such a way that adding this, introducing this new degree of freedom to cure the singularity exactly did the right job in creating the hole on the world sheet. And so what I'm currently looking into with common buffer is to see whether something like that is also realized for string on ADS5 process 5.
I guess I was asking if anything is known on the field theory side. I mean, if you just compute the partition function of a gauge theory on whether the... I mean,
you mean, field theory side being the CFT side?
Yes, not for
now. I mean, the answer we want to desire is clear, that we want to reproduce the sum of a Feynman diagram.
Okay, thank you.
Related maybe to the last question, what's the n-dependence of these effects again, please?
Yes, well, the counting may be slightly different from what you are familiar with. But basically we have g amnil and the g amnil square n times n. And I'm identifying the g amnil square as the string coupling constant. The string coupling constant are always the case for all string closing.
Right.
And the t is a parameter of the string theory. Now, since we are fixing t as a parameter of closing well sheet, so you could well say that you could have normalized this into here, and you're saying that we are expanding 1 over n to the 2g minus 2. That's the same thing.
Okay, and so you have singular contributions in that that expansion.
Singular contributions for six, for each order in 1 over n expansion, but small to this coupling. If we are referring to our result in the last transparency, here, for example, then we are looking at the small to this coupling for six order in G, that is for six order in 1 over n expansion.
Okay. No, I'm looking. Oh, okay. We'll discuss it later.
I will talk about gauge string correspondence, and I will try to convey to you my conviction that this is a central problem in physics. It's a long problem, and much progress has been made in the last 5 years since string 97. And my plan is to very briefly review this progress, and then to pass to new results, and then to unsolved problems, to unsolved questions. The basic reason why I find it so interesting is that gauge string correspondence actually relates two unrelated things.